Hello everybody, today we are going to see a very special and interesting video. Now we are going to see 25 plus different types of chutneys. All these chutneys are made with Before going to the video, please like, share and subscribe our channel. Now we'll start it. First we are going to see coconut chutney. For this the required ingredients are grated coconut 1 cup, fried gram 2 tablespoons, chopped ginger a small piece and also 3 green chilies. I have taken all the seeds. The preparation is very easy also. Now I have put all the 4 ingredients together in the blender and made it as a coconut chutney. After grinding like this, we must sort it. For sorting, I have taken 2 teaspoons of gingerly oil and put little seeds of mustard and urad dal. I'll show you how to do it now. Now turn on the gas stove and keep a pan like this. I am going to sort the chutneys in the similar way for 5 chutneys. So first add gingerly oil to it. When the oil heats, put mustard seeds. I repeat, I make this for 5 chutneys. The sorting is very similar way. Now add 2 teaspoons of urad dal. Let the urad dal turn to brown color. Now add curry leaves. I wash them well. Turn off the stove now. Now add 1 tablespoon of salted mixture and mix it with the chutney. After grinding, add salt to the chutney. Now our coconut chutney is ready. We are going to see our second chutney. For this, we are going to take 3 ingredients. First one is 2 teaspoons of chili powder, 3 garlic and required amount of salt. This chutney name is rose chutney. It is very famous in Tanjore side. Now our rose chutney is ready. You can make it at home very instantly and also it's very tasty too. If you don't have chili powder, you can make it with sambar powder. It also enhances the taste of chutney. Now we have grind this. If you add gingerly oil to it, it will taste good. And also we are using raw chili powder for this chutney, so you must add only gingerly oil or ghee to it. You should not make it with refined oil or some other. You must only take a little amount of chutney as it's very spicy. So I hope you like this chutney. Now we are going to see another chutney. It is tomato onion chutney. For this, required ingredients are, I have taken 2 tomatoes, one big onion and red chilli, two red chillies and salt to taste. We have to grind it without sorting, and after grinding we have to temper it with ginger oil and mustard seeds. Come, I'll show you how to make it.
First, let us grind this.
Now we are going to make tomato chutney. Let us pour. I have taken 2 teaspoons of oil. Let the oil get heated. Now our oil is heated. Now add cumin seeds. Now add red chilies. You can add red chilies according to the spice you need. Add some onion. I have taken big onion, cut into small pieces like this, because I am going to hand ground it. Let us saute it for 2 minutes. Add little salt. Now add tomatoes. I have taken here 2 tomatoes, cut into pieces like this. If you are grinding it in mixer grinder, then you can add big pieces. As I am going to hand ground it, I have made into small pieces. It will be very tasty with idlis, dosas, and also you can have it for rotis also, for chapatis. If you want more spice, then you can add more red chilies. Now add some turmeric powder. Now let us off the stove. Let us cool this and then grind it.
Now our tomato chutney is ready. This you can taste it with idlis and dosas. It will be very tasty, as I said.
Now we are going to make garlic chutney. The ingredients needed for this is, I have taken here 2 garlic pieces and 3 green red chilies and some salt. If you want more chutney, then you can add these ingredients more. Now we shall grind it.
I have ground the garlic chutney. Now for this we are going to add tempering. This we have to eat it by adding gingerly oil, because it will be little spicy. Now our garlic chutney is ready.
Next we are going to make ginger chutney. This chutney contains medicinal values. When you have nausea or vomiting sensation, you can have this chutney. It gives good digestion. The ingredients needed for this is, I have taken some mint leaves and small piece of ginger I have cut into small pieces, some salt and small piece of tamarind, and 1 red chilli. Now we shall grind it. Before grinding this ginger chutney, we shall lightly salt it in oil to remove the raw taste of mint. Now add 1 teaspoon of oil.
Then add the meat. Pop them in medium flame. Now add red chili, tamarind, salt, and then ginger. While having vomiting sensation, you can have this as side dish for idli. Now let us cool this and then grind. Now we are going to hand grind ginger chutney. Now our healthy ginger chutney is ready. It will be very tasty. When we have a vomiting sensation, it is very good for our health and it is also good for digestion. Now we are going to make rich gourd chutney. Now we shall cut the rich gourd. I'll cut this corner first. Take this out. I'm going to use small piece, so I've taken this. We shall cut these corners. We're going to use the skin now for the chutney. Pulp can be used for other dishes. Now we shall first wash this and then we shall cut into small pieces. Now I have washed them. Now cut it into small pieces. The skin of rich gourd is very good for health. It has more medicinal values. The pulp is not a waste. We can use it for other dishes. Many of them throw off the skin because it looks like it is hard, but it is very good for health. Now I have cut it into pieces. Now we shall make the chutney. For making the chutney, I have taken the ingredients. These are the ingredients needed for this. I have taken small onion. Five I have cut it into small pieces, 2 red chilies, 2 teaspoons of urid dal, small piece of tamarind and 2 pieces of garlic. This we are going to grind it along with the skin of rich gourd and then I'll show you. Now take a pan and add 2 teaspoons of ginger oil. Then add urid dal. Grind it until it becomes golden brown color. Add asafoetida powder along with it. Now add green chili, red chili, garlic, then tamarind, and then fry them. Now add onion. Toss it now for 1 minute. For all chutneys, if you toss it and then grind, it will give a good taste instead of grinding it raw. Now add rich curd. Toss it for 1 minute. You no need to cook rich curd because we are going to make it as a chutney. Already we toss it for 1 minute like this. It will get cooked. So you can add little water and then grind it. Now off the stove. Let it cool and then you can grind it. Now our healthy rich curd chutney is ready. It is very delicious. You can try this recipe. It is very good for health.
Now we are going to see three chutneys. All the three are going to be in same method. So I am showing it together. Now take handful leaves of pudina, small onion, one tomato and one red chilli. And also for this I have taken curry leaves, small onion, one tomato and one red chilli. For third chutney I have taken one handful of coriander leaves, one onion, one tomato and red chilli. The common ingredient in this is cumin
seeds.
You must sort it with cumin seeds and grind. After tempering we must grind it together.
All the three chutneys we will grind and show you. Here we can use small onion or big onion. I have taken here big onion. You can also add small onion. We have to sort it with cumin seeds one by one and then grind it. After grinding all the three chutneys, we will show you.
Now we have prepared three same method chutneys. This is curry leaf chutney. This is coriander leaf chutney and that is pudina chutney. For all the three chutneys, we have used almost same ingredients. Only the leaf differs.
Now we are going to make wild grape chutney. Wild grape is also called perandai in Tamil. So for making perandai chutney, the ingredients needed are, I have taken small piece of perandai. This perandai we should not use as it is like this. We have to remove the skin because it will be too itchy if we eat it. When we remove the skin, it will be like this. After removing the skin, the other ingredients needed for this is jaggery. I have taken a small piece of jaggery. Because it is itchy, we should add jaggery to it. And some curry leaves, tamarind, sesame seeds, peppercorns and some ginger. And for sorting, we have to take some cumin seeds and urid dal. These are the ingredients needed. We should add some oil and
sort it first and then grind. This perenda is very itchy when we eat, so we have to add this jaggery, then only we have to eat it. It has many medicinal values. It is very healthy chutney. Now our tasty perenda chutney is ready. It is very good for health and it contains medicinal values, so we should take at least once a week. But it is itchy for some people because of that we have to add jaggery while preparing this. Without jaggery we should not grind this chutney because it is very itchy when we eat it. So please add jaggery without fail. Now we are going to make chilli curry leaves chutney. For this the ingredients are curry leaves, small onion, red chilli and salt. We should roast this in oil and then grind it. Now we are going to see tamarind coriander chutney. These are the simple ingredients which are needed for it. I have taken some coriander and a small piece of tamarind, one red chilli and some salt. We shall grind it and our chutney will be ready. Now we are going to make hand ground chutney. We shall add all the ingredients. It will be very tasty compared to chutneys ground in a mixer grinder. Olden people used to do masalas and everything. They'll grind in this type of grinding stones. It will not take more time to. It'll be ready in a few minutes. Now our chutney is ready. We shall transfer it into a plate. Now our coriander tamarind chutney is ready. It will be very tasty with dosas and idli. No, there is no need to temper it. Tempering is not needed for this chutney. You can directly have it.
Now we are going to see another delicious chutney. For this, this chutney name is peanut chutney. It is very famous in Andhra. The required ingredients are, I have taken 4 tablespoons of peanuts, 2 small onions, and a small piece of ginger, 2 green chilies, and required amount of salt. This peanut chutney is very healthy. It aids weight loss. It is also heart friendly. It has good cholesterol that reduces weight. Also, it is one of the best snacks for diabetic patients. It also helps with stress and anxiety and also good for skin and hair.
This is raw peanut and not cooked one.
Now, we'll see how to make the chutney.
Before grinding this peanut chutney, we have to sort it in oil. Then we shall grind it.
Now, we are going to make peanut chutney. For that, I have taken a pan and added 2 teaspoons of gingerly oil. Let the oil heat. Now add green chilli. Then add chopped ginger. After that add chopped onion. Gently fry it in the oil. After sauteing for 1 minute, we'll add the peanuts. Now we'll add the peanuts. It is not roasted peanuts, also it's not cooked one. You should use raw peanuts. Peanuts are very high beneficial for women. You can see that women have many health problems like thyroid. Also, for women in PCOS and PCOD. Also, it is useful for men too. It reduces the diabetes and makes person healthy. It also reduces the stress and anxiety level. If you have any blood pressure or any other disorders, you can make peanut chutney and have. It is highly protein rich and calcium.
Now our peanuts are roasted. Now switch off the stove. Let it cool for some time.
Add salt and mix it well.
Let this cool and then we shall grind.
Now our peanut chutney is ready. You can just add the tempering. We have already made it. This is very yummy for all the breakfast items like idli, dosa. Also very good for when pongal. Now we'll go to the other chutney.
Next we're going to make green chutney. The ingredients needed for this is, I've taken some curry leaves and one big onion finely chopped and two red chilies and some salt. Now we shall grind it. Before grinding this green chutney, we shall sort them in oil because this curry leaves has raw smell. Because of that, we'll lightly fry this in oil, then we shall grind it. I have taken 2 teaspoons of oil. And I have taken some cumin seeds. You can add cumin seeds or you can skip them. Now add red chilies. I have taken 2 red chilies. You can add according to the spice. Now add the onions. The chutney which now we are making is for 2 persons. All these chutneys 2 persons can have. Light tossing is enough. Now add curry leaves. Now we shall off the stove. Let us cool it and then grind it.
Now a delicious green chutney is ready. You can add more spice if you want. It will be very tasty with idlis and dosas.
Now we are going to make vadagam chutney. If you don't have vadagam, then you can use these ingredients. If you have vadagam, then you can add coconut, vadagam, tamarind and then red chilli. You can add these four ingredients and grind. If you don't have vadagam, then you can use these all ingredients. For making vadagam chutney, I have taken 1/2 cup of grated coconut, 1/2 teaspoon of fenugreek seeds, 1 teaspoon of urid dal, small piece of tamarind, 3 red chilies, some cumin seeds. I have taken 1 teaspoon of cumin seeds and 1 teaspoon of Bengal gram. Now we shall grind it. Before grinding it, we have to sort them in oil.
Now add some gingerly oil. First, let us add fenugreek seeds. Fry them till it becomes brown color. Now add Bengal gram. Now add urid dal. Fry them in medium flame. After urid dal becomes brown color, then we shall add green chilies, cumin seeds and tamarind. Red chilies, cumin seeds and tamarind. Now it gives a nice aroma. Next we shall add the grated coconut. We should not fry coconut for a long time, so we just fry them for 1 minute. Now add salt. We are going to hand ground it. Now off the stove. Let it cool, then we shall grind.
Now our tasty vadagam chutney is ready. It is very good, the combination with the idli, chapatis, and mainly for chapati it is very good combination. For dosa too it is very good. Now we are going to make spice coconut chutney. For the ingredients needed for this is, I have taken grated coconut, 1/2 cup, and here I have taken roasted gram, 2 teaspoons, 2 red chilies and 3 pieces of garlic, and here I have taken some salt. Now we shall grind this. Now we have ground the spicy coconut chutney. It is a very good combination with puri and ven pongal. Try this recipe, it will be very tasty. Now we are going to make simple green chili chutney. The ingredients for this needed for this is, I have taken 2 big onion and 4 green chilies. I have removed the seeds and some salt. These 3 ingredients are needed. Now we shall grind it. Before grinding this, we have to sort it in oil. Then we shall grind it. Now
let's add 1 teaspoon of gingerly oil. For all chutneys, for sorting, I am adding gingerly oil. It is very tasty and it is also good for health. First, we shall add the green chilies. Chop them for 1 minute. Now add onion. Along with it, add salt needed. Chop them for 2 minutes. If not, make onion VC size. Now let this cool and then we shall grind it.
Ta-da! Our another chutney is ready. That is a simple green chili chutney is ready now. We can have it with hot hot idlis and dosas. It will be yummy and delicious. Also, this is one of my favorite chutneys. You too, please try it and comment in the comment section below.
Now I'm going to prepare tomato tukku. For this we need a little more oil than the other chutneys, because it will be very tasty if we eat it with this gingerly oil. Now the oil is heated. First let us add mustard. Now add asafoetida powder. Now I'm going to add tomato puree. I have taken 3 tomatoes, grinded into nice paste. This dish we have it will be very delicious. It won't be watery, it will be like a thick paste. During traveling time, it is a good recipe for chapati, for dosas, for rice too. You can mix with boiled rice and eat. It will be very tasty. It is only a single ingredient dish, only tomatoes. For spice, we are going to add chili powder and salt for taste. That's it. Only these ingredients are needed for this dish. It takes some time because water has to evaporate. We can keep this in a high flame and cook. You should not add water and grind the tomatoes. You should grind it without water. Then it can be made quickly. Now we are going to make the delicious roast chili onion chutney. only three ingredients are needed for this, that is onion. I have taken small onion. It is for this chutney, small onion will be very tasty. Small onion, red chilies and some salt. These three ingredients we have to grind it. Before grinding it, we have to roast it in oil, that is gingerly oil. We have to roast it nicely, then we should grind it. I'll show you after grinding it. Now we are going to see curry leaves coconut chutney. The ingredients are same as that of coriander coconut chutney, that is grated coconut, red chili, small onion and salt. Instead of coriander, we are going to add curry leaves. Now we have to again roast this in oil and then grind it. I'll show you after that, after grinding. And this chutney is mint coriander chutney. The ingredients are same as that of coriander coconut chutney. That is, instead of coriander, we are adding mint leaves. That is, mint leaves, grated coconut, small onion, red chili and salt. We have to roast it and then grind it. This is onion coconut chutney. The ingredients for this is small onion, grated coconut, green chili, red chilies and salt. We can also use green chilies for this. We can directly grind it. This is onion red chutney. The ingredients for this is small onion, red chili powder and salt. We need not roast it, we can directly grind it. We should add gingerly oil and then have it with idlis and dosas. It'll be very tasty. Now we have prepared all the chutneys. How many chutneys we have prepared. It looks colorful. Here we have prepared idlis, dosa, puri and chapati. You can also use some of these for boiled rice. Like this. We can use this tomato toku for boiled rice. And we can also use this toku for chapati. While traveling to out stations, we can use this as a roll chapati. We can apply in between and take it as a roll chapati. It will be very tasty. It is a lunchbox recipe. See, the idlis are soft, hot. We can have this along with all these chutneys we are going to taste. These are the medicinal chutneys which we have prepared. This is the rich ghat chutney. And this is the well grape chutney. And here we have the ginger chutney. And here we have peanut chutney. These are all medicinal chutneys which we have prepared now. It contains high medicinal values. We have to use this regularly. And other chutneys which we have made is also good for health. All these chutneys we have made with simple ingredients and which is readily available at home. We have not used any ingredients which is not available in market. Mostly we have used onion, tomatoes, red chilies, green chilies. These are the ingredients which we have added, but we have made variety of chutneys. So here you can see that we have made so many chutneys with simple ingredients, and we are going to have it with hot idlis, dosas, chapatis and puris. Some are spicy chutneys. You can add gingerly oil and have it. And this is spicy coconut chutney. You can have this with puri. It is a very good combination with puri. You can add ghee with this chutney and have it with puri. It will give added taste. This we have prepared it within few minutes. That is Each chutney takes only 2 minutes to be prepared. Mostly all the chutneys we have sorted in oil. So you can use it for 2 or 3 days, it won't get spoiled. Except coconut chutneys, you can use other chutneys for maximum of 2 or 3 days. We have told the correct proportion for all the chutneys. You can note it down and you can make each chutney for each day during breakfast. Kids will love to eat it. We have told the correct proportion for all the chutneys. You can note it down and you can make each chutney for each day during breakfast. Kids will love to eat it. This is a very useful video. You can save this video and watch it at any time. We have told the correct ingredients in correct proportions. The taste of every chutney will differ, although we have used similar ingredients. Please share this recipe to everyone. Some of the ingredients used in this is collected from our home garden, like curry leaves, green chilies, coriander leaves, mint leaves. These all we have collected in our home garden. I have attached the video after this recipe video. Please watch that too. If you like this video, please like, share and subscribe our channel. And please put on your valuable comments below. We believe we have made a useful video. See, these are the ingredients. These are the recipes which we have prepared today. Thank you.
Now we have come to the upstairs. Our daily routine is plucking flowers from all plants. You can see these flowers have bloomed because yesterday evening we couldn't pluck these flowers as it was raining. So we are going to pluck it now. The name of this flower is jasmine. In Tamil they will say Nithyamalli.
There are many types of jasmine flowers. One of the type is this. The other type I'll show you when I go down. This is a plant in front of the house. This is a way.
See, this is the jasmine flowers which we have plucked earlier. The root is here for the plant.
Here we have another type of jasmine, that is Kundumalli in Tamil they will say.
See here, these are buds now, we should not pluck them now.
Tomorrow morning they will bloom, we will pluck them tomorrow. Tomorrow morning. See, now all our buds now, because yesterday we plucked all of them which were bloomed. So today most of them are only buds. The secret for multiple buds is we have to see here, if you can see, the ends are dried up, no buds are at the ends, so we have to cut it here like this, cut the ends like this. See here now new leaves are coming because we have cut it earlier. Like this it will bloom, new leaves will bloom. So we have to cut the ends like this. See here it's dried up, so let's cut it here.
See, you can see here all the leaves are too big and no buds are coming
here, so too we have to cut.
You no need to cut the whole branch, just pluck off the leaves.
See here it is dried up, so this branch won't be able to germinate flowers, so here we have to cut. In many cases if you see, there will be many big leaves, but see here we have small leaf coming here, but here we have big ones. We have to pluck the leaves alone here in this case.
See, this is the jasmine flowers which we have plucked earlier. The root is here for the plant.
Here we have another type of jasmine. That is Kundumalli in Tamil they will say.
See here, these are buds now, we should not pluck them now.
Tomorrow morning they will bloom, we will pluck them tomorrow morning. See, now all our buds now, because yesterday we plucked all of them which were bloomed. So today most of them are only buds.
The secret
for multiple budgets. We have to see here, if you can see, the ends are dried up, no buds are at the ends, so we have to cut it here like this, cut the ends like this. See here now new leaves are coming because we have cut it earlier. Like this it will bloom, new leaves will bloom, so we have to cut the ends like this. See here it's dried up, so let's cut it here.
See, you can see here all the leaves are too big and no buds are coming.
Here so too we have to cut.
You no need to cut the whole branch, just pluck off the leaves.
See here it is dried up, so this branch won't be able to germinate flowers, so here we have to cut. In many cases if you see there will be many big leaves, but see here we have small leaf coming here, but here we have big ones. We have to pluck the leaves alone here in this case. See, this is the jasmine flowers which we have plucked earlier. The root is here for the plant. Here we have another type of jasmine, that is Kundumalli in Tamil they'll say. See here, these are buds now, we should not pluck them now. Tomorrow morning they'll bloom, we'll pluck them tomorrow morning. See now all our buds now, because yesterday we plucked all of them which were bloomed, so today most of them are only buds. The secret for multiple buds is we have to see here if you can see the ends are dried up, no buds are at the ends, so we have to cut it here like this, cut the ends like this. See here now new leaves are coming because we have cut it earlier. Like this it will bloom, new leaves will bloom, so we have to cut the ends like this. See here it's dried up, so let's cut it here.
See, you can see here all the leaves are too big and no buds are coming.
Here too we have to cut.
You no need to cut the whole branch, just pluck off the leaves.
See here it is dried up, so this branch won't be able to germinate flowers, so here we have to cut. In many cases if you see there will be many big leaves, but see here we have small leaf coming here, but here we have big ones. We have to pluck the leaves alone here in this case.